Right now on Apple Valley News Now, live at 5, Republican candidate for Governor Dave Reichert is in the Tri-Cities tonight. We'll tell you why. Also,
health officials sounding the alarm about an increase in cases of dengue fever. I'm Jacqueline Lee. We'll have more coming up.
Plus, we are taking you to the Central Washington Fair. What's new, what's hot, and what to know this year. Stacy?
That looks like fair food to me. Weather-wise, another beautiful day in the books. Very quiet going into the weekend. I'll get you updated here in just a few minutes.
This is Apple Valley News Now at 5, on your side.
And a very good evening. Thank you for joining us on this Thursday. It is September the 19th, and I'm Austin Reed. First at 5, Dave Reichert, the Republican challenger to Democrat Bob Ferguson, in the race for Washington governor, will be in the Tri-Cities tonight. Reichert is hosting a party called a Path to Victory Dinner. The public event starts at 5:30 p.m. and will be held at 7016 West Grand Ridge Boulevard in Kennewick. That's right across the street from Kennewick's Fire Station No. 3. Reichert comes to the Tri-Cities after debating current Attorney General Bob Ferguson last night in Spokane. We'll bring you more on the debate tonight at 6. Now, we will also have a news crew at tonight's Reichert event in Kennewick, and we'll bring you more tomorrow night right here on Apple Valley News Now. Other news tonight, many may wonder exactly what the Climate Commitment Act is achieving in the state of Washington. Well, a company called Greenline Insights is a research firm that evaluates jobs and economic development in a number of states. It recently conducted a study in Washington about the Climate Commitment Act and what impact it's having. We spoke with the founder of Greenline Insights about what the study results revealed in terms of jobs and economic impact over the next 8 years if the program continues.
Will generate over 45,000 new jobs in the state, as well as $9.1 billion in new economic activity. And that puts this in a range of job creation that is really exceeding other types of state priorities. So it's really compelling results at a baseline.
Greenline Insight says the jobs that are being opened by the Climate Commitment Act are in many categories, such as construction, manufacturing, transportation, architecture, and engineering. Time now for a first look at our weather. It has warmed up during the day as of late, but will that continue? First alert, Stacy Lee, live in our weather center with the very latest. Hi there, Stacy.
Hey there, Austin. Yeah, just a few degrees warmer than we were yesterday. Absolutely beautiful day outside Columbia River, looking good. All those salmon and steelhead fishermen, I've been watching them out on the river today. 83 degrees, winds are light at 3 miles per hour. Our sunset at 6:59, losing 2 minutes of daylight per day. Temperatures elsewhere around the area, anywhere from the lower 70s into the 80s all through the region. Now, the 24-hour temperature change from yesterday, couple of degrees, just like we said, 3 to 4 at points during the day. We were a good 8 or 9 degrees warmer in Walla Walla and Dayton. So enjoy that warmer temperature trend, because we're going to start dipping down with those temperatures in the coming days. And then we get another little warm up into next week. Yakima and Walla Walla typically at 79 degrees right this time of year, but we'll be climbing back into those 80 degree temps. So what to know for tonight? It's mild. Those temps are going to be a little bit cool overnight. Might need a coat. Breezy winds continue in some areas. Some areas will calm down. We'll see cooler temperatures tomorrow, and fall officially begins on Sunday. I'll break it all down in my first alert full weather forecast. Austin.
Stacy, thank you. Well, the strike at Boeing by 33,000 members of the International Association of Machinists Union, which reached its 7th day today, has already cost the company and workers $572 million. Correspondent Michelle Esteban has the very latest tonight.
A backlog is keeping Boeing supplier Newtek Industries busy for now. But already, this aerospace tooling machine shop in Mukilteo is feeling the trickle down of 33,000 union machinists on strike and rolling furloughs for thousands of Boeing employees, including managers and corporate execs.
There are plants that we are not able to deliver to at this moment.
With production paused across many key programs, including the 737 MAX, Boeing CEO said in this memo to employees, our business faces substantial challenges, and it is important that we take difficult steps to preserve cash and ensure that Boeing is able to successfully recover.
That affects us a lot. It affects deliveries. We're not able to make deliveries. They're not accepting tools. They're not ordering things.
Workers will be furloughed for 1 week every 4 weeks.
I feel bad that the other employees, such as our Spia brothers, are having to bear some of this burden that Boeing is putting upon us.
From Everett to Auburn and all the picket lines in between, frustration from the machinist union leadership.
I believe we're doing the right thing.
The union describes the first day of mediation with Boeing since the strike as frustrating.
They are determined and they want what they want.
What's that tell you about like the longevity, the potential longevity of this strike? Does it tell you anything?
That they will hold out until they get what they want.
Back at the Mukilteo Tooling Machine Shop, hope for a quick contract that rekindles a Boeing culture longtime Boeing employees. And Evans remembers when her dad opened this shop.
It's not the same Boeing that I came to work for back in 1986.
That reporter for the story. Do stay with us for updates in this story. All right, other news tonight, we're talking about Yakima, the Central Washington State Fair kicking off Friday at State Fair Park in Yakima with some new twists this year, especially when it comes to the food. There are 22 new food items available, like the Barbie funnel cake, the twisted pickle, and a pineapple rice bowl. The theme this year is Harvest the Fun, with a new farmer's garden featuring the history of the apple industry, a new Funville area with free apples for kids, pony rides, and are back, along with a petting zoo, plus a new online food map to help you find your fair food favorites faster.
Once a year, we all just indulge on things that are crazy and wonky, and we want to keep innovating. You know, that's one of the things. We're 80% tradition and 20% innovation. Let's continue innovating in the food.
We'll have more about everything the Central Washington State Fair has to offer this year. That's coming up on Apple Valley News Now, live at 6. Yakima's long-running boutique gift shop, Fiddlestick, celebrated its grand reopening earlier today. The shop's been around since 1976, almost 50 years, but it was forced to close back in April after a car burst through its wall and closed, or caused rather, thousands of dollars in damage. They've since rebuilt and are back open, featuring a Christmas preview.
So grateful to be open again, and just for the loyalty of our customers and the great community support has been awesome.
The shop is located at 16th and Summit View. It is open 9:30 to 5:30 Monday through Saturday. America's Best Restaurants swings by the Mid-Columbia region this week to feature local businesses. This organization shows off the food and talks with the owners to highlight truly local businesses. Always the goal for both the Bonfire in Walla Walla and Stick and Stone in Richland, keeping local a priority.
Well, we do everything from scratch. Try to keep it local. A lot of us are family and stuff like that, so this is a big deal. And
like, we only do local beer, local wine. We try to get our produce local, support other local businesses.
What these two businesses hope to get out of this experience with America's Best Restaurants, that story tonight at 6. Well, it is a virus that U.S. health officials are urging extreme caution. ABC's Jocelyn Lee explains.
Health officials are calling this an unprecedented number of locally transmitted cases for a region where dengue didn't exist before, urging residents to take caution.
A cluster of dengue cases are now under investigation in Los Angeles County. Three cases have been reported, all locally acquired, meaning officials say the people infected have no history of travel to areas where dengue normally spreads. Dengue fever spreads through mosquito bites.
Local transmission occurs when a traveler who has been infected with dengue while abroad returns to LA County and gets bitten by a local mosquito that then becomes infected. This now infected mosquito can then bite an individual that has not traveled, resulting in a locally acquired case.
Symptoms are similar to the flu, like high fever, severe headache, and joint and muscle pain. While dengue fever is rare, according to the CDC, there are more than 3,000 cases this year, the majority of them in Puerto Rico. That's about double the number from last year. And globally, there's a record number of cases. Mosquitoes thrive in warm, wet areas. Officials say as climate change alters our weather patterns, it increases the risk of mosquito-borne diseases like dengue, West Nile, and Zika. Warmer temperatures for a longer time helping mosquitoes thrive.
As climate change and severe weather around the world impacts climate and mosquitoes' ability to find new homes and get situated in new places, different types of mosquitoes spread different diseases. And so every time you have a new mosquito introduced in a new place, then you have to take into consideration all the diseases that that area may not have had to worry about previously.
Health officials say there are easy ways to prevent dengue fever, like wear repellent, wear long sleeves and pants, and avoid standing water.
Officials want to clarify that the disease cannot spread person to person and instead can only be spread through mosquito bites. Jacqueline Lee, ABC News, Los Angeles.
Apple Valley News Now live at 5 is just getting started. Still ahead, the chicken dance was in the spotlight at One Richland School this morning. Riley Fitzgerald will take us there. Plus, a special statue will be on display in Kennewick in just a few days. Details ahead. And Stacy will return. She is previewing your weekend weather. Stay with us.
In the ICU, I see patients suffering from asthma and lung disease. So the fact that Initiative 2117 would mean more toxic air pollution in Washington is unacceptable for my patients and their health. 2117 is a bad deal for Washington.
Hot tub, hot tub, hot tub. Major manufacturers and warehouses clearance of new 2024 inventory Friday through Sunday. Happo Center Pasco. Over 100 hot tubs on display and everything must go. New 2024 inventory. Hot tubs starting at $29.95. All inventory 40 to 80% off. See the revolutionary swim spa in action and save up to 60%. Trade-ins welcome. Free delivery. We'll even haul away your old hot tub. Worry-free installation. 18-month interest-free financing. Millions of dollars of inventory must be sold. Happo Center Pasco. Free admission. Free parking. Call 833-SPA-SALE.
Enjoy bowling here at Triple Play, where fun is always in season. French fries are fun, which is always in season here at Triple Play. Speaking of fun, did you know it's always in season at Triple Play?
Dude, what's with dropping the tagline?
The marketing ladies wanted me to push it.
What did they offer ya?
5 pizzas.
Gonna share, right?
Of course.
Triple Play has fun attractions for everyone, including go-karts, mini golf, and many more, all attached to a cozy hotel.
Oh, thanks.
Growing up, I watched my mom serve our community by helping others through our church. I watched my dad, a workers' comp attorney, help people get benefits when they were injured at work. I'm Bryant Sutton, an attorney at Bothwell & Hamill, a law firm that exclusively helps people win workers' comp and Social Security disability. Let us go to work to get you benefits.
Call 509-584-4411, Bothwell & Hamill.
You love the internet, but do you love your internet? Do frozen screens make your heart melt? Do buffering wheels give you butterflies? Didn't think so. You should meet Ziply Fiber. It's faster, it's friendlier, it's fiber. Ziply is fiber optic internet. That means no lag and no buffering. Gotta love it. Ziply Fiber. Call 1-888-GO-ZIPLY or visit ziplyfiber.com/GO-ZIPLY. Plans as low as $10 a month.
When your child has asthma, every day you worry about the next attack. So the fact that Initiative 2117 would mean more toxic air pollution makes it out of the question for me. 2117 is a bad deal for Washington.
Judy Justice.
And I'm just getting started.
Weekdays at 4 on Apple Valley News Now.
Welcome back, everybody. Well, this morning, Christ the King Catholic School in Richland held its annual student event, the Chicken Dance Competition. This involves groups of students coming up with different themes and then performing the chicken dance. Now, I got the chance to judge the competition this morning, and our Riley Fitzgerald tagged along with the camera. Let's get a glance at how it all went down.
Third place, it's a fifth grade group, and the chicken dancers, the name of the group was Blast from the Past. Are you ready for second place? Also from fifth grade, it's our 80s chicken. The 2024 winner of the Christ the King Catholic School Chicken Dance Competition are sixth graders, the group Gnomes versus Knights. Congratulations.
The competition is second through seventh grade, so the competition, they do that to second and second grade, and then in final entry, they do their entire class dance together.
And apparently that was the Gnarls Barkley version of that song. So I've got that song and the chicken dance stuck in my head. Congratulations to everybody who participated, though. Now, the Sausage Fest, that starts tomorrow. Organizers say there are no road closures for the Sausage Fest Friday or Saturday in Richland, but there will be on Sunday for the Ironman 70.3 contest. More details about the Sausage Fest, though, coming up tonight at 6. Other news, a piece of history is being displayed at D.S. Watkins Gallery in downtown Kennewick. It is the half-scale statue of Billy Frank Jr. The statue will be added to the National Statuary Hall in Washington, D.C. Every state in the country gets to have two statues in the hall. The Washington State Arts Commission says until recently, states were not allowed to change their statues that were in the hall when it was established. Billy Frank Jr. was a tribal leader and a treaty rights activist, and the Washington State Commission brought the piece to the Tri-Cities after SoCo submitted a proposal to allow people to learn just who he was.
He's truly a historic figure and someone that everyone in Washington State should know about and be really proud of. The second is that these statues, they only get developed maybe once in every two or three generations. So like every 50 years, you'll have the opportunity to learn about a statue as it's being developed before it gets finished and sent off to Washington, D.C.
You can go and see the half-scale statue for free this Friday, so tomorrow, and then also Saturday. It's going to happen from noon until 5 p.m. Again, that is in downtown Kennewick. Check it out if you can.
From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Stacy Lee.
Well, we're going to chicken dance our way into the weather tonight. Dust Devil Stadium in Pasco, beautiful. Traffic is moving along. That's good news. 83 degrees. Winds are light at 3 miles per hour. Our sunset now is happening before 7 p.m. And we'll lose 2 more minutes tomorrow. That temperature trend from yesterday, that cool air coming down. Now, we did have a little bit of a warm up here, but we're going to continue to see that cool air pulling down with this odd jet stream that's dipping way down south. There goes that low pressure system out. Our warmer day today, and then we have a cold front moving over the top of us. It's going to cool our area down just slightly. It'll be nice and mild on the west side. The only buddy that has any chances of rain heading towards the weekend are the Cascade Mountains and possibly Ellensburg, a very slight chance on Sunday at 10%. Everybody else in our viewing area should remain nice and dry. Current wind speeds, it's been blustery and windy. We're starting to mellow out a little bit. It's still windy in the Dalles and Ellensburg. These are the sustained wind speeds, and our wind gusts are gusting up to 30, 33 miles an hour there in the Dalles. So again, winds will decrease tonight for most of us. We'll still continue to see those breezy to gusty winds, especially in the Kittitas Valley and in those mountain gaps, and of course down the Columbia River Gorge. That's why we are the wind sail capital of the world. Here we are overnight tonight. We're in the 40s and 50s, 49 Dayton, 51 Walla Walla, 48 Tri-Cities, 46 6 in Yakima. For tomorrow, the Cascades and Kittitas Valley will see some breezy winds up towards Snoqualmie Pass with those temperatures in the 50s as you head further to the east, 60s, and then you'll hit the 70s in Vantage and Ellensburg with those gusty winds once again in the Ellensburg area. Yakima Valley, Sela at 75, nice mild temperatures, beautiful day, a little breezy further down the valley as you head towards the Tri-Cities area. In the Columbia Basin tomorrow, expect light winds 5 to 8 miles an hour. Beautiful, lots of sunshine. Everybody in the 70s all the way up into Connell and our Blue Foothills and mountains and the foothills of the Blues. Milton Freewater to Walla Walla, 70s, and those upper elevations like Ukiah and Meacham in the 60s. If you're hitting the road this weekend, overall pretty pleasant. Some gusty winds to be expected in the gorge. Cool temperatures in the mountains. Showers could develop on Sunday. Here's your weekend forecast for Seattle. We're in the 60s. There's that rain coming through on Sunday. Pretty mild over there. If you're heading to the Portland area, a little overcast on Friday, but looking good for the rest of the weekend. And then if you're heading up north to the Spokane area this weekend, it's going to be beautiful up there with temperatures in the 70s. A little cool at night, so do pack a light jacket. Yakima 7-day planner. Here we go. Look at this. A nice little string of 70s. Fall officially begins on Sunday, and then we'll have a little bit of a bump up next week with temperatures back to the 80s. Tri-Cities looking great. 70s through Monday, back to the mid-80s by Tuesday. Our news director thinks that's hot. I don't think so, but Ellensburg will have those breezy to gusty winds on and off, and temperatures back into the 80s early part of next week. Here's what it looks like in Walla Walla for the next 7 days. Gorgeous over the weekend. Good golfing weather, wine tasting weather there. It's going to be beautiful with temperatures back to the mid-80s. And in Hermiston, very nice. A little breezy for you guys tomorrow, but fall's looking good and temperatures are nice and mild. This is like my favorite time of year, Austin.
I can't believe fall is almost here officially.
That's right. Get out that pumpkin spice.
That's for sure. All right. Thanks, AC. Up next on Apple Valley News Now at 5, we're going to bring you tonight's spotlight. We're headed to Yakima and we're discussing the law. Don't go anywhere.
Smoke City for Less. We are open 7 days a week with now 5 locations.
Roy Jones Jr. Boxing returns to Legends Casino Hotel September 19th as India's Mandeep Jangra is back and looking for another championship belt. This time, he's taking on undefeated Nicaraguan challenger Nilo Guerrero for a vacant NBA Junior Lightweight World title. Tickets start at just $40 and can be purchased at Ticketmaster.com or the Legends Gift Shop. Don't miss Mandeep vs. Guerrero in a clash of unbeatens for the Junior Lightweight World title belt, plus other exciting bouts September 19th at Legends Casino Hotel in Toppenish.
Let Quantum Legal protect you and be your champion on the legal battleground. Whether it's a fight for justice in the face of criminal accusations, personal injury claims, or workplace accidents, Quantum Legal is your unwavering ally. An aggressive offense is your greatest defense. Quantum Legal is the sword and shield you've been seeking. Your best defense, Quantum Legal.
At Fred's, not only do we guarantee the best prices, we prove it. Our live price card keeps things transparent, showing you real-time prices. No gimmicks, just the best prices on in-stock, get-it-today inventory. And when it comes to beating the big box stores, our prices aren't just competitive. They're unbeatable. Check out how we stack up. Whether it's this amazing new fridge or this energy-efficient dishwasher, Fred's prices are always the best. At Fred's, we sell appliances. Only appliances.
Save thousands on the new Revolutionary Swim Spa at a one-time sale.
Friday through Sunday.
Hapo Center Pasco.
Exercise with low impact.
Swim the entire year and stay in shape.
Teach your kids to swim.
Unwind and save thousands.
Avoid the expense and maintenance involved with a pool.
Swim, exercise, and relax in your new aquatic exercise swim spa.
Installation in one day only.
New 2024 inventory.
18-month interest-free financing.
Millions of dollars of inventory must be sold.
Hapo Center Pasco.
Free admission.
Free parking.
Call 833-SPA-SALE.
It's game day. Tackle high prices with great deals from Overturf Kia. The new 2025 Kia Sportage Hybrid gives you 3 great ways to save fuel. Available with a fuel-efficient gas engine, a gas-electric hybrid, or as a plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. A new 2025 Kia Sportage Hybrid with all-wheel drive starts at just $31,940. Plus, get 5.99% interest for up to 72 months. Overturf Kia at the base of the Blue Bridge in Kennewick.
The White Card, a powerful resource for former Hanford and DOE employees. If you worked in the area and have come down with cancer, lung disease, Parkinson's, or renal failure, you may be eligible for financial compensation and healthcare services. A simple phone call can get the process started. Atomic Home Health. Don't wait. Call today.
Check this out. It is our Thursday night spotlight at 5.
We always love this. Beta Nelson Injury Law Firm is proud to have three lawyers honored as the best lawyers in America and the best lawyers, the ones to watch in America for 2024. Terry Abeda and Ron Nelson and James Boyer, all partners at Abeda Nelson Injury Law, have been named to the best lawyers in America for 2024.
Congrats to them. And a quick reminder, if you have an idea for the spotlight at 5, send me an email. It's easy, Areed, A-R-E-E-D, at applevalleynewsnow.com. All right, we've got a final look at weather, plus
we're going to break down what's actually happening when we switch to fall. So right. You don't want to miss that.
Stay tuned. First, here's World News.
Coming up next, we have breaking news coming in right now. Reports a judge has been shot and killed inside his chambers, what the governor of Kentucky is now saying. And a major scandal erupting in the race for governor and a major battleground state in this race for president. Stay tuned. We're next.
Apple Valley News Now, the official television home of the Seattle Kraken.
For generations, hardworking people have relied on Ford F-Series trucks, making them America's best-selling trucks 47 years straight. This is the next generation of built Ford tough.
I'm loving a pizza.
Loving a pizza.
Tony's Big Cheese Pizza.
Loving a pizza.
I've been loving a pizza. Tony's Big Cheese Pizza. And Yakima's home.
Mom, let's order a large Mexicana pizza.
For Tony Big Cheese Pizza.
Good idea. I'll order it now. Tony's lets me order online or by phone.
When you want lunch or dinner the delicious, easy way, come to Yakima's Hometown Pizzeria.
We can't wait to see you at Tony's Big Cheese Pizza in the Safeway Plaza at 24th and Nob Hill.
If you'd rather be here or here instead of here, then you gotta start here with Honda, the most trusted brand on the road according to KBB.com. Honda's also the best deal on the road 10 years in a row. And that includes the award-winning Honda Passport and Honda Pilot, both winners of Car and Driver's Editor's Choice Award. And right now, well-qualified buyers can get the Honda Pilot with 2.9% APR financing. For details, see your Southeastern Washington Honda dealer.
Hot tubs, hot tub, hot tub. Major manufacturers and warehouses clearance of new 2024 inventory.
Friday through Sunday.
Happo Center Pasco. Over 100 hot tubs on display and everything must go. New 2024 inventory. Hot tubs starting at $29.95.
All inventory 40 to 80% off.
Come see the Revolutionary Swim Spa in action and save up to 60%.
Trade-ins welcome. Free delivery.
We'll even haul away your old hot tub.
Worry-free installation.
18-month interest-free financing.
Millions of dollars of inventory must be sold.
Happo Center Pasco. Free admission.
Free parking.
Call 833-SPA-SALE.
I'm attorney Jeff Kreitz.
And I'm attorney Megan Changaroya.
For 5 consecutive years, Tamaki Law has been voted Tri-City's best law firm.
Your trust fuels our commitment.
Your support inspires our dedication.
For 30 years, Tamaki Law has been your choice as the law firm that fights for the justice you deserve.
Again, on behalf of Tamaki Law, thank you for your vote of confidence.
We are so grateful to serve our amazing community.
For generations, hardworking people have relied on Ford F-Series trucks, making them America's best-selling trucks 47 years straight. This is the next generation of built Ford tough.
Thank you for making Apple Valley News Now's Good Morning Northwest and ABC's Good Morning America the most watched morning news on local TV.
Now that's good.
What's new, what's now, and what's next? Plus, first alert weather every 10 minutes. Apple Valley News Now, on your side.
Next DT.
Really good fun.
Brad Pitt and George Clooney bring wolves to Hollywood. Fresh off his viral Emmy moment, we're with Joshua Jackson.
I was not expecting that.
Next DT.
Tonight at 7 on Apple Valley News Now.
Let's have your viewer photo of the day end on a high note.
It always makes us smile. Yeah. Take a look at your screen. We've got Rick Zimmerman sending this in. This is the moon setting, because remember it was setting like during the day hours, but mm-hmm. You can see it. That was that super moon. Good job getting mm-hmm. that picture, Rick. Remember to have your photo on TV, that QR code on the right side of your screen, or go to applevalleynewsnow.com. All right, let's talk about fall beginning on Sunday. Now, here is what it is. It's the autumnal equinox.
Okay. I practiced that too,
and I couldn't get it down. It's the Earth axis. It's tilted neither away or toward the sun. Equal amounts of daylight and darkness at all latitudes. So that's what it actually means. And then things start to change as we head towards the winter equinox and so on. Plus we lose 2 minutes of daylight after, you know, after, as we've been heading towards fall since summer. So, all right, let's break down tomorrow. Temperatures in the 50s there, midday close to 70, but if you notice, a little bit cooler. It was kind of warm today when we took the dogs for a walk around lunchtime. In the afternoon, look for temperatures in the mid and upper 70s. So overall, pretty quiet weather going forward for the next couple of days. A quick sneak peek at the Tri-Cities and Yakima 7-day forecast. So pretty mild, slight chance of showers in the Cascades, a little tiny chance in Ellensburg. Overall, a great weekend forecast.
All right, thank you so much. Thank you for watching us here at 5 o'clock. We're back at 6. World News coming up next. I'm Austin Reed with Stacey Lee. Hoping your news is good news.
Have a good night.